Hey everybody, this is the second edition of the re-up of the videos of exercise because my videographer is back from vacation. She was forced to go on a cruise to Hawaii. The suffering. Anyhow, today is deadlifts. Yesterday we did shoulders. And the day before I did back, arms, and chest. So the last time I did this, which we didn't film anything for 2 weeks, well, we had 70 pounds, if I remember right. Let me go back through here. Always keep a record of what you're doing here. And we had, where are they? Here we are, deadlifts here. 70 pounds, we did 3 sets of 12, and then 5 and 2, which is 7 sets of 8. That's 10 sets total. So, remember, 10 reps is an ideal. You can go up to 15 reps before it ceases to become a repetition exercise. So, 10 to 12 reps, when you're trying to bounce weight. So, I want 5 pounds when you're actually squeezing the muscle and doing it properly is a lot. You'd be really surprised what 5 pounds will do if you're actually squeezing the muscle. You're not squeezing the muscle, back off the weight, so you can actually really, really get a good squeeze, because that's what's going to make you grow, that and your diet and your sleep. So when you do deadlifts, I'm going to just do stupid lightweight, and then we'll warm up. You can do it with a long bar, you can do a short bar, you can do it with dumbbells, whatever. You know, they have cages around you so you're going off the side like this. The problem is if you're off of the side like this, you can't get a proper back squeeze. The concept of deadlifts is that you're working the whole back section here all the way up in your entire back. Well, your entire back is your entire shoulder, muscle, chest complex. So when you come up, or this is just a warm up here, you want to start down here and bring it up in front and squeeze like this. If you don't have that shoulder squeeze, you're not getting the full back. This is a back exercise. That's the primary thing. The back is the entire back of the body. The entire back of the body. And when you squeeze the shoulders, this is all rotator cuff and chest and your delts and everything. Everything comes into play. So this is also why I'm doing this after my back, arm, and chest, and then just shoulder and then deadlifts. So it's 8 o'clock. More or less, and I want to make sure I'm properly healed from my shoulders before I do this, because you don't want to overstress the region. That's how you create an injury. So, again, this is just a warm-up. Stupid lightweight. This is only 7.5 pounds, and I'm just stretching. This is just a warm-up. This is a stretch. You've got to flex the shoulders, your lats, everything, if you want this area to grow. And it can grow. Even if you're a girl, to really, really large proportions. It's just a matter of, you know, what do you want your body to look like? You know, bodybuilding is about causing your body to look a certain way because that's what you choose to look like. It's the oldest form of body alteration. Now, while I'm stretching here, the Olympics were originally performed naked. All the athletes were naked. You follow me? Because it wasn't just the event, it wasn't just winning the event, it was a stylized depiction of the human body, which was very beautiful to the ancient Greeks. That's why a lot of the statues are naked. The gods were very muscular. A lot of the statues that you see, they're young looking, they're very slim. Guess what? A lot of them have no penis, because that's what they had. They were slave boys. The slave boy was a submissive, and the penis was for the dominant, for the master. That's what they looked like. It was taken off. This is fact. It can be easily researched. So, if you compare yourself to a Greek god or a Roman god, be careful what you're comparing yourself to. Because if you don't have a big muscular body, you're comparing yourself to a slave boy. You understand? So, always stretch. And flex a little bit. I took a hot shower about an hour ago, half hour ago. So I wanted to make sure I was healed. That hot shower, what it does is it gets rid of your lactase, gets rid of your soreness. If you're sore, you ain't ready to work out again. It'll work out when you're sore. But your hot showers will get rid of your lactase. You don't need to take chemicals to do it. All you need to do is reflush the area with blood. The blood will rinse it out. Well, that's what heat does. So hot showers. I try to take 3 a day. 1 a day, you can be sore for 3 or 4 days. Take 3 a day, you're ready to work out the next day. So again, this is just a warm up here. I want to flex, I want to feel everything. I want to make sure everything's ready for what I'm going to do, okay? You don't have to use weight. I'm just using a little light weight, a little light resistance. All weight is resistance, remember that. So this isn't about, look at me, I'm doing this and this with 300 pounds. So one of our Instagram friends, Brad, he was over visiting. He said, we should work out, make a video. Hopefully he's gonna come over and we're gonna do some deadlifts. It's one of my favorite exercises as is his. And since at my place, I want, you know, he's a trainer, but every trainer trains differently. So he says he does it with 300 pounds. Okay, fine, we're gonna have another straight bar for him and a 300 pound set. It's like, okay, well, that's what you're doing. But follow the exercise how I'm doing. If you can't do it and follow the weight I'm doing it, even though I'm much lighter weight, then back off the weight and do it like this. He's been doing it for 15 years. 15 years, he should be just King Kong, man. Just King Kong. He's got some muscle, but he's not King Kong. So there's a reason why. So we're going to start here in a second. Let me write down my time. So time is 7:53. Time start 7:53 p.m. And it's deadlifts 70 pounds. Now I wanted to go up in weight. But I want to make sure the body's ready. Like I said, 5 pounds, if you really do this right, is a lot. When you start doing reps and sets, it's a lot. So I'm going to keep it at 70 pounds. I'm not going to go up yet. We're going to keep it at 10, instead of 12. And I'm going to see if I can get 10 sets of 10. Yay, if I can. And then I'm going to, if I can, if you know, because again, I have some tendon issues here. With this hand, and your hands and your forearm can wear out before your muscles do. If I can, I'm going to go past my 10 sets into other sets, even if it's dropping down to 5 reps. We'll see what I can do without overstressing the area, because tomorrow I'm going to take a day off. So, let me pull this back here. And again, watch your positioning. These are marked for a reason. Watch your feet positioning. You want to use the mirror because you want to keep it even when you come up, because it's real easy to get off just a little bit like this, and then you're going to create a muscle imbalance even if you don't already have one. So a real good tip before you do squats and deadlifts especially, take a shit first. Get rid of anything that's back there, because you're going to squeeze all down here. And squeezing when you're full down there ain't a good idea. Just ain't a good idea. So, bring it in. And again, knees just a little bent. Don't do this. You wear out your knees and you blow them out. Knees just a little bent. You gotta pick it up. Just a little bent. That's all you want. Bring it up close to your body. And flex back. That's one. Watch yourself in the mirror. Keep it even. Two. Three. Four. Five. 6. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten.
Okay. Your first set is always basically a warm-up set.
You can always feel you can do more. At this set, I'm going to just keep it at 10. Our little break, let's come over here, write down our 10. I have my water ready if I need it. Deadlifts and squats. The hardest exercises that you're going to do on a bodybuilding level. They're also the most fun exercises you can do. If you're not enjoying it, back off the weight. You'll enjoy it. Six. Seven. To write it down. Now it's still pretty hot, so I'm sweating. If I start getting too overheated, I'll have to turn the fans on. But that's annoying. So keep the fans off if you can. So now if you notice, my hands are like this. I'm warmed up now, and I do have weaker tendons here, and you can lose your hands and your forearms when you do this. So now I'm going to flex like this for a couple sets. And then as I get tired, then I'll not flex like that anymore. Always warm up first, your first sets, before you put the flex in. But you want, when you do a full body exercise, you want to bring in as many muscles as you can. That's the concept of a full body exercise. And that's what deadlifts are. So, now we flex it, see? One. Two. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Okay. There we go. Knock that back down.
3. Stretching. Here we go. Flex the forearms again. We begin. 1. Sets. A little water here. Okay, blue. Chuckle. You might touch me.
Oh my God, you might touch me.
You might touch me.
You're not a pit bull, that's the problem.
Yeah, I'm not a pit bull. If I was a pit bull, you'd come up and smack me in the face. You have to play with me now. Okay, I have to turn the fans on. I don't want to get overheated. Sorry about the noise. Sets. And again, once my forearms start getting tired, then I won't flex anymore. I just want to put it in as much as possible. A lot of deadlift guys don't want you to go like this. Well, when you do that, you can't properly flex your shoulders, and you certainly can't work your forearm. So half your exercise went out the window. Drop the weight, build it up, and make it work for the entire body. I didn't have that. Maybe on my third month, I didn't have that. It wasn't there. I had no lats at all. I had no chest. I had nothing. I didn't have this. I didn't have that. I am not even on 3 months yet. Okay? I'm actually getting a little somewhere. I didn't have that either. Maybe I know something. Pay attention. Because I do know. We begin. Flex. Make sure you line up your body right. Thank you.
Sets of 10 in 15 minutes. Bap, 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 bap. Jumps your testosterone. You follow me?
That's why they're called sets.
That's the whole concept. How can we make the body go woof on testosterone?
My lens popped out.
Oh, your lens popped out.
Yeah, so.
Okay, we'll grab the camera here.
Okay, I
gotta. You gotta go. Fix your lens, Tom. We got a little camera thingy here. Okay, we still have a giant mess. We're getting there. I'm going to continue this as good as possible while she does her lens. So, we don't really got to see what's going on, but hopefully this will give you an idea. We're on our sixth set. Should be back in a little bit. Six sets of 10. So yeah, by now you should be really feeling it. If that's all you can do is six sets, five sets, that's okay. Build it up gradual, don't increase the weight. At the end of the day, that's your exercise. And you've got 45 minutes. So if you need to take time in between your sets to hit the 45 minutes and bring it in like this, that's okay. You bring it in, you bring it in, you bring it in. So you go pop, 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 pop. And then you raise the weight. That's what makes it aerobic. Okay, this is 7 sets. We've had 10 reps so far in each set. Watch your positioning. So you're even. Three more sets of 10 to get where I want to be. So I'm not where I can just go pop, pop, pop through the whole thing. Until I can, I'm not ready to increase that weight. This is my only exercise. I got 45 minutes to do it in. Careful, you got to be about this. It's really easy to, especially if you're dyslexic like me, to get a little off. You got to use the mirror. You want your bar to be straight, you want your body to be straight. If you don't have the mirror to watch yourself, you cannot tell. Let your feet be straight. Okay. Again. Exercise right, drop the weight way down here. Do it right and squeeze the muscles. This ain't show off time. Not at all. Drop that weight down. You want to be doing this for 300 pounds? No problem. You will get there. Give it time. If you want to be a power lifter, you want to get in shape and then start going for as much weight as you can. See, a lot of lifters try to go up and cap, they pop a bicep, they pop a this, they pop a that. No, thank you. Hit 10 sets of 10. If I do that, that's the first. You know, last time I did 3 sets of 12, and then the rest were 8s. 10 sets of 10, those extra 2 reps, man, that makes a huge fucking difference. It's that last rep. That's where you're going to get your gains. Last rep, done right. If you can't do that last rep correctly, do a half rep and lay it down. You're good. Do it next time. Okay. I'm going to center myself in the mirror. Over this way. Bring this over here. Starts a little bit. When I set, sets of 10, I'm going to pop, 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 pop. Before I go up and wait, I want to do that with all 10 sets. 7:53. So we've been doing it for more or less 30 minutes. About 15 more minutes to go.
We're definitely
well above our 10 sets.
How far?
I have no idea.
But we're going to find out.
Without pushing it, without forcing it. Get your feet placement in, especially when you're tired. It's stupid ass important. You want your body even. It's so easy to get off a little bit. Hurts the spine, gets a muscle imbalance. But really watch it. This is what the mirror's for.
Set 10. Yay. Wow. Oh, man.
Yeah. Okay. That's good. That's real good. Do up to 15, but still within my 45 minutes and however many reps, not forcing them. That's the best I've done this routine of getting in shape. Okay? That's the best I've done. Give me an idea where I was at before. In composite with the fact I'm using water bags in prison, which we're not supposed to use, go to the hole. So I'm doing my squats and my calves and my deadlift at the same time. 100 pounds with moving water bags on a chair, on a stable chair, because the water bags hang down. The water bags add momentum and therefore a little more weight. I'm doing squats, calves, squats, calves, boom, 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 boom. 10 sets of 10, up on the chair for deadlifts, 10 sets of 10, with my 45 minutes. Non stop, bam, 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 bam. 100 pounds. So I'm a long way off of that, baby. There's no way for me to do 120 or 130 pounds. I'm using water bags. I can't put a second water bag on. It's just not happening. There's no way. Well, I had to maximize the weight I had. Try to really squeeze the muscle. Okay, this is our 11th set. I don't know how many reps I'm going to do. I don't know. But if I can't squeeze or go back, we're good. You have to squeeze and go back. You have to finish the motion. If you can't, back off. Oh, we're good. Positioning the feet, watch that. Eight there. That's good. That's our 11th set. Set. See how many reps we get. Sets. And remember, you're tensing everything. I feel this. The whole chest, the back, the rotator cuff, everything you feel. The abs, all through here. Everything. If you don't feel that, you're not doing it right. Back the weight down and squeeze those muscles. 13 set. You do not ever want to go past 15 sets. Just don't. I don't know how many reps I'm going to get. If I can't even do 5, I'm good. I got to finish this one to see if I'm going to do a 14 set. I don't know. So I'm watching my knee. I had that knee injury, so I got to really watch it, see how it feels. Really easy to pull that thing right back out again. I got to be careful. Muscles to see how they feel. I don't want to overdo what I'm doing here. It's real, real easy. Maybe like ow, 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 back it off. It's a little twist with those back muscles. How's it feel? Okay, there it goes. Okay, I'm gonna call that good because I only got 2 minutes left before my 45 minutes. So we got 13 sets, 10 sets of 10, and then 3 sets of 8. So that's good.
Turn off the fans?
Yeah, we'll come back in a minute.
All right.
Okay. I'm going to give you another water, because that one had a fly dip in it. But you, like you're telling me, you don't pay attention.
This place is suffocating with all the dust bugs. Yes, it is.
I
don't care.
Such a child. Well, waiter, I don't want to fly in my suit.
But then put a cover on it, okay?
So that way I just don't let the flies in.
How about you?
You're the ones complaining when flies buzz your ears and blah, blah, blah. Huh? Okay. Again, hydrate. Grab yourself a nice ripe banana.
Do you need a tray?
I need a knife. When you're this tired, I don't even trust in pulling the banana back. Need blood sugar. I need blood sugar now. I'm shaking. That's a lack of blood sugar. You gotta have that blood sugar in your body. Again, so your protein on one side.
Put it in the freezer. Mm-hmm. But that's in good bugs.
You don't want to all worry about bugs, but you let them flies in.
I don't care.
I don't care. Why won't you?
It's a different kind of bug, so stop already.
You gonna care when I smack you upside the butt?
Don't think
I got
that.
Two knees. I ain't afraid to use them.
Oh my gosh. You are funny.
If you ask me hard enough, I'll break out the rope.
Yeah, you're yeah, right.
A real good time.
Yeah, right. I'll be a fantasy land here.
When Daddy says do it, Boo Boo says, hi, hi, yeah. Should I jump?
Boy, I'm just a little bit here now. Delusional.
And I'm going to give you some doses of reality in a minute. Mm-hmm. My adult child. Oh, boy. Okay. Again, this is cactus honey, royal jelly. Look up royal jelly online. One of the best foods you could possibly eat. And we get this at the local Korean market. You can get it online. Most of them, they say royal jelly. They got nothing. That one actually has it. You can feel it. I'll get my little eggs. You know, woman, they don't call me the Punisher for nothing.
Oh, shut up already. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Look at your daddy. Look at your daddy. Okay. When I build up in size, I've got to add more eggs into the diet because of my weight. And enough eggs basically becomes the equivalent, a natural equivalent of anabolic steroids. All natural. So if you don't like the egg whites, you can eat that cooked if you want, but you've got to have the yolk raw. That's the magic. Raw yolk, raw. Raw, raw, raw. That is the magic. Do not cook your egg yolks. There are very few superfoods in life that are real.
That's one of them.
Actually, that's one. Mmm.
Anybody who wants to get lean and build up lean muscle, doesn't matter if you want to get big and become He-Man, you just want to be lean and ripped. It's called having muscle in your body. And that's what I'll do. Gotta build that up. So you're gonna take and warm these up.
You don't want to put the cold in the body.
The water's warm. Cold eggs are a bad idea. Close your metabolism now. So 5 eggs, 30 seconds. Boom, now they're warm. Not cooked, they're warm. A little bit of the white might be cooked, that's okay. Egg white protein, the egg white is actually easier to digest than the liquid egg white, but it's the egg yolk where the magic is. So don't cook your egg yolk. This up a little bit, all nice and even warm here. Some of it's cold and some of it's hot. I want it warm when I swallow it, not cold, not hot.
There we go, that's what it looks like. Shabam, that's magic food.
This is absolute miracle.
Go back to the beginning of the videos. I'm not even 3 months in yet. I started doing those deadlifts with a battery charger. It's maybe 25 pounds. I'm not even 3 months in. We're just starting. You don't really light it off till you've been doing this for 6 months. That's when you really start to go, wow, man. Yeah. Take 6 months. You're not even halfway there. So that's that. I'll see you guys on the next video edition of Todd's Prison Workouts.